is blessed with a second sight, the seventh son of a seventh son, could have foreseen Hearts on the very last day of the season playing for the championship, requiring only 1 point, comparing that with the disastrous start in August, and yet that, I think, underlines the great achievement of the Edinburgh side. With Celtic breathing down their necks, they have brought to the city something like 10,000 supporters, eager and looking forward to the start of this game, but particularly at the end, when they hear the final whistle, they're in their mass ranks, the confidence that they'll take the championship back to Edinburgh. Well, there's a marvellous atmosphere inside here, and I'm sure it's affecting both sets of players, but oblivious to it all is the referee, Bill Crombie, from Edinburgh. Here we go, and if a scriptwriter had come up with an end-of-the-season climax like this, I think it would have been rejected as being too fanciful, with one side trying desperately to get into Europe for the country, like Glove Street and Ibrox. McKinley to take it. Oh, it's a dangerous-looking ball, and that is a corner kick. And immediately that Hearts defence looking slim-swinger. Much too short. Played wide. Just kept in Cahoon. Rising above them, and there have been worse offences than that, but that is given as a free kick. Other side it goes, Harvey is there. And again. And Sandy Clark back in the fence. Well, just down the street from here in the game against Dundee United, we saw Sandy Clark playing marvellously in defence for his side, getting back, covering perhaps more ground than any other player in the park. Bobby Connor. Oh, McDonald's all in his own. That was very surprising. And away goes Clark, the man who broke up that move in the first place. Great play by the centre forward. Kidd going forward. There's Kidd, the captain. Can he get his shot? And he can. And a great counter-attack by Hearts. I mean, that has been the real stamp of the play this season. Breaking away like this. Well, it's actually the depth of it, away from virtually their own goal line, was the real quality of that break.
Get on the side of the guy following up is Whittaker. Robertson. Cahoon. Kai. Nice deep turn, but can he get rid of it? He can't. Crowded out once again. McKinley going forward. Seem to be running out of ideas. Brown, and that's too much.
And again, the same hands of Henry Smith down on it, clamping it. Very good break by McKinley. The game is needing that kind of break and depth from defence as McKinley provides. Bit of wrestling going on right away there, but I think Henry was pushed and it's a free kick. This is McKinley for Dundee on a pitch that looks slightly bare. That's a beautiful flick by Brown. And I think of a ladies tackle, yes indeed. Free kick. I know it's going to be very difficult for these players to keep out of the minds the thoughts of the happenings in other places of the country, like Glove Street and Ibrox. McKinley to take it. Oh, it's a dangerous looking ball, and that is a corner kick. And immediately that Hearts defence looking slightly nervy. Number 8, you notice there, Ian Jardine in the side from last week, as is Roddy McDonald. The two changing. It'll be the in-swinger. Much too short. Played wide. Just kept him Cahoon. Oh, there's boy Cahoon likes to pick up at his own in midfield and charge at the fences. Brown. It's all a bit hard, and that was a late tackle, not that one, the one before it. Finch looks as if he's going to play very finely. Sandy Clark could run round, kill for the penalty. The waving play on, and that was a very late tackle by Mackay. I think born of exasperation more than anything else. Free kick. Well, this was a claim for the penalty. Sandy Clark going across, and I'll tell you what, penalties have been given for less than that. One or two of the players thought a whistle had gone. Robertson after it. He'll be content with that throw-in. Obstruction. The ball is almost put out of the ground. Hart with the pressure on again. Now, in a tight and tense game like this, they've really got to try and exploit these situations. They are always opportunities. That was a near post. And this time a corner kick. Will swing in viciously, I would imagine. Yes, it does. Corner is back covering. Hart's turning the screw ever so gently with Whittaker up at the near post. Robertson going forward. And Escahoon. McDonald just pulled that. There's Neil Berry with the shot. There might have been a deflection, yes. Three corners in the space of a minute. That's a message to the supporters that they're straining every sinew in this match. John Robertson just taken away. Cahoon's at the back. A lot of players in that penalty area, including Roddy McDonald, doesn't get it cleanly. Jardin, Robertson. There's McDonald. Gary Mackay, hands. No. Looked like it from here. The break by Dundeen. That was very odd indeed. Well, perhaps it was something of an optical illusion, but it looked like hands. I don't know where Sandy Clark is indicating what happened or whether he wants the ball put to him. Probably the latter, there it is. Straining every sinew, as I said, and away goes Cahoon. Clark was lying handily at the back. There he is again. Second chance. Nice little shuffle. Sandy Clark. When he went from Rangers, perhaps the man thought that his career was taking a plunge, and he has really turned round on his critics and played a man's part, real man's part this season. There's a low one, McDonald. Many a game this man has turned, both for Hearts and for Celtic, with the head. He didn't get this as cleanly as he would have liked. It seemed to be just too much under it, or else it would have taken a more accurate path. Here's Connor. That's a superb pass. Brown. Oh, he turned too much. He couldn't get clean control of it. Beautifully set up there by Robert Connor. Kit. Club captain. Robertson tries to go up. Crowd of blue jerseys. Right in the middle, and now Connor. That's long, it's towards Brown, and he seems to hesitate slightly. And Bobby Connor's passes are now producing some very significant moments in this game. Well, that's a two-way control they have there. Now, Alec Gray, who, by the way, knows all about nerves, but he played in that marvellous League Cup game against Celtic years ago for Party Thistle. He's in communication with Archie Knox. Bobby
worse offences than that, but that is given as a free kick. Other side it goes, Harvey is there. And again. And Sandy Clark, back in the fence. Well, just down the street from here, in the game against Dundee United, we saw Sandy Clark playing marvellously in defence for his side, getting back, covering perhaps more ground than any other player in the park. Bobby Connor. Oh, McDonald's all in his own. That was very surprising. And away goes Clark, the man who broke up that move in the first place. Great play by the centre forward. Kidd going forward. There's Kidd, the captain. Can he get his shot? And he can. And a great counter-attack by Hearts. I mean, that has been the real step of the play this season. Breaking away like this, well, it's actually the depth of it away from virtually their own goal line was the real quality of that break. The end of the side of Mackay following up is Whittaker. Robertson. Cahoon. Mackay. Nice deep turn, but can he get rid of it? He can't. Crowded out once again. McKinley going forward. Seems to be running out of ideas. Brown, and that's too much. And again, the safe hands of Henry Smith down on it, clamping it. Very good break by McKinley. The game is needing that kind of break and depth from defence as McKinley provided. Final pass just a little too long. Here's Harvey though. That's an interesting situation. It's a one against one in terms of there's a touch. He took McDonald on, decided to lay it to the side. There it is. Wanted to try and beat him, pushed it to the side as Shannon came up. And even though there was a deflection, they can't beat Smith. Well, Alec McDonald has kicked every ball. And that larynx of his is taking a real bashing. Clark. He'll play it wide. I would think that Hearts now badly need a goal. Kidd. He's almost through. Here's Robertson with a chance, just gapped away there. They really badly need a goal because we hear Celtic are winning by 3-0. The players perhaps don't appreciate that yet, but they will as they go in at the interval, and that will put an almost pressure on them. And we're only about 11 minutes away from that. That was a very good run by Walter Kidd, the captain. Slightly wrong-footed himself more than anything else. Cluster of players. And look at that, Robertson just a trifle unfortunate as he went after it. One minute to go to the halftime whistle, and that first half must have been emotionally draining for both sets of players. Marginally more so for Hearts, I would have expected. And there it goes, in fact, coming rather sooner than we expected, but that is the halftime whistle. And when the Hearts go off the field here, they're going to be met by the news that Celtic are leading by 4 at Love Street. And if that first half hasn't been hard for Hearts, and it certainly has been, then the second half is going to be even more draining. I would expect that although they have the ability to hold out, maybe the tactics would be to try and get one very quickly in that first part of the second half and thus ease the pressure. It's been a very nervy afternoon, and that is exemplified by the fact that there's so few chances near goal. But at this moment in time, even though it's still nothing each and Celtic are well in front, Hearts technically are still in the driving seat. And on comes Kenny Black for Hearts. Hearts obviously realize the importance of winning ball in midfield, and this boy wins it as well as anybody else as we start the second half. An amazing announcement at that time by the PA saying
our supporters keep off the ground when you celebrate winning the championship at the end of the game. Well, that means that the PA man must have a crystal ball. We'll see. Jardim. Bomber goes black. Nice run forward by Robertson, but I think the flag was up. Yep. Was indeed exactly where Duffy is beckoning for the ball. By Harvey, is anybody in there? Yes, leg tackle, free kick right on the halfway line, and there is little doubt that Hearts cannot afford to lose this game, with Celtic running up as we hear now five goals. Simply cannot afford to lose the match now. Opening ball, there's Ronnie McDonald. McKinley. Corner. That's McKinley. Ooh, that was a useful ball, and Henry Smith, for some odd reason, was a little slow in going for it. Although it's easy enough for me to say that. From this angle, it looked easy enough. It may have done a bit of a dip or a swerve. As you can see from here, he suddenly went for it. Now watch, Smith was slightly late. Yeah, so he'll get the free kick for that. Watch the amusement of Kidd. I can't even believe it. So I said about Kidd, not only useful in defence this afternoon, but some of the best attacking has come down the right through Kidd. Harvey. Corner with a quick one. There's a great chance. And again, that hot defense survived. They always have the extra player. That's a great quality of this team. And at this stage, their backs are against the wall. And even though they have this huge support behind them, they know they're having their moments of great strain, and this was one of them. The goalkeeper just with that slight misjudgment, and in Harvey came for the kill, and just knocked away by Berry. Well, there we are. He'll need a new shirt, but... Well, that's where the accident happened, and I think, as again, quite accidental, as Henry went in after that, he ripped the shirt almost off poor Henry's back. There's Berrien. Lovely little touch there by Robertson. Now, this is where Hearts are lethal in the break like this. He's going through and he's on. Can he make it? It's Cahoon and he can't. And they don't even get the corner out of that. And that was one of the best chances of the game. There he is. Now Cahoon has done this so often this season. Many a manager will tell you how suddenly Hearts on the right are struck with this man. And he put it a trifle too much to the side. Oh, and that was agonizing for the wee man. And we're getting the substitution as Albert Kidd comes on. And McKinley going off with about 16 minutes of this second half play. One more midfield player is off. And he'll be going forward. Clark getting the touch. Putting it anywhere. Robertson. they've done and stopped well. Well, it looked like a free kick to me. Clark. Corner. Well, it's a tempting one that is just knocked away. There's a brilliant save. Oh, superb. Ryder's out, but it's just over, and that goalkeeper surely has done so much for Hearts this season. A monumental save. Just watch this. I've already said he's had the save of the season from Malpas. But look at this. And it was blind, it was late, and he gets a touch, and that is superb. Brown. Headed forward there by many. Jardim at the back. Umakai very slack. Black is in. Oh. Nicely floated in. Barry goes now. This could be very interesting. It's two against one. Oh, and he's slow, slow, slow. Oh, that was very bad play by Cahoon. He had Robertson totally uncovered beside him. And that would have clinched the championship, and he put it to the side. That's one that Robertson would not have missed. Kidd. Tries a 1-2. Cumbersome, but he gets it. To try the shot on, and again the Hearts defence extremely well organised. Now Robertson, can he bring it down? No, he can't. They lack that control up front. It's been a weakness of them this afternoon. And away goes Bobby Glennie, thundering towards that Hearts goal mouth. That's a header, and it's the third. Henry going up for it. Very good move by Dundee, coming initially from Bobby Glennie, then corner, and that neat glancing header there. Although, having watched it again, I think Henry Smith had that under that eagle eye of his. Donald just keeps it in. That's a very good ball. Cahoon and Duffy brilliantly did that. Little put away. Ball under control. Solid legs on an old heat. There's no offside, and here Robertson with a great chance. Glennie goes with them. Robertson! Oh, he did the right thing, yes. He wasn't going to mess about and try and take on Bobby Glennie again. Might have been a suspicion of offside, but he didn't care. He went right in there and decided to lash out at it. There it goes again. Here's Cahoon this time, and Glennie gets that little ping-pong pass there. Didn't quite come off. Eight minutes left. Kidd. Runners good round the outside, and McDonald happy to step in to see that corner kick. Swinging in and swinging in very dangerously. There's a goal! Kidd has scored! Stewart has put Dundee in the lead quite astonishingly. And there is but 7 minutes remaining of this match. Here it is. Swinging in, the little touch on, and there was a substitute kick to put Dundee in the lead. And this is now so agonising for Hearts. Will this championship disappear from the very eyes? Kit, what a marvellous substitution this has been for Dundee and Hearts. Looking slightly ragged, it's a great chance for Bennett. 2-0. A brilliant goal by Kit, his second. And Hearts look in abject misery, while the Dundee supporters are celebrating a quite astonishing victory now, because there are only 4 minutes left, and that was a superb goal engineered by Kidd. Away he went, taking on the defenders, looked for the classic 1-2, he got it and finished with great aplomb. Goes to Duffy. Seconds remaining, and there goes the final whistle. And let me repeat that Hearts apparently have lost the championship. They've gone all these number of games, 37 undefeated, and then suddenly on the last day, the last afternoon, the last 10 minutes of this championship, they lose out. Utterly cruel. An afternoon that started out with great expectations for the people from Edinburgh, and then suddenly these two goals, a quite deserved winner, they say, for Dundee. No question.